There are so many social networks out there, and if you're like me, you're not on just one social network, and so we have to figure out how to differentiate social networks. As social media has matured, so have the networks that we are engaged on. And if you're like me, you're on multiple social networks. And so we have to figure out, how do we be present in different ways on different platforms? So LinkedIn is not the same as Twitter, which is not the same as Facebook. And in this episode of the vlog, I'm going to share how I differentiate the social networks and how I engage differently on each of these platforms. So there are so many different social networks out there, and some of them we engage in and then we kind of move away from, and things have changed. You know, imagine if we continued to be active on MySpace or Google Plus or some of these platforms that look like they were going to be a big part of the future and have diminished in engagement. Now, there might be opportunities for you still on those social networks. They're not dead, at least not yet. And so we have to figure out, where is it that we're going to engage, and how do we differentiate ourselves on those platforms? And so my recommendation is that you're not present on every social network. You really can't be. And what we used to do is basically say, I'm going to set up an account on Facebook and MySpace and on Twitter and on LinkedIn and on Pinterest, and I'm going to use a platform or a tool like Hootsuite, and I'm going to just post once and push it out everywhere. And for some that's worked, and some that still works in some ways, and I don't know that it's bad to have your content on multiple platforms, but it is hard to engage everywhere and to actively engage. And so it is important to differentiate the various social networks and figure out how will you be present on this network, and how will you be present on that network, and what will your voice be on different networks? Because the reality is, we also have different activities we're involved in. And so LinkedIn is a professional network, where Facebook is a more personal network, and Twitter is more of a news network. So I'm going to share how I differentiate these social networks and digging into each one. So let's start with Facebook. Facebook is king when it comes to social media. It's where most of the engagement activity happen when it comes to the social side of social media. And so I use it primarily personally. So I have my Facebook profile, which is me as a person, and I share family pictures. I share, you know, interesting entertainment, things that are interesting to me, and I share that with my friends on Facebook. And so my real life friends, some of those are colleagues and some of those are just friends from high school and different places through life where we've connected and we have a friendship. So I share a lot on Facebook through my profile. Now, some of it I'll share some professional things and some interest professionally, but for the most part, it's personal. Now, I also have a page on Facebook, a personal page, that I share things about articles I've written or news things that I'm interested in, and more professional sides of things. So I am involved in both sides of Facebook, both from a personal side with my profile and a professional side with my page. And so that's how I differentiate. And then I'm also a part of various Facebook groups. And so some of those I'm engaged in personally. And so these things might be like local garage sale groups or things that are interesting, some hobbies that I'm involved in. And then some of those are professional. So I'm a part of some entrepreneur groups, or I'm a part of some various leadership groups that are interesting to me professionally. And so I kind of split on Facebook between the two. I would say 90% of my engagement on Facebook, though, is personal. And so when I get onto Facebook and when I use Messenger, I'm using it personally. Now, shifting to another network, Twitter. Twitter has been a social network that I've been very active on for probably a decade now, very active and engaged on. I would say 95% of Twitter for me is news. So I share a lot of articles on Twitter. I connect with people professionally, and so a lot of even like my writing and my video content I'm promoting out through Twitter, and I'm connecting with people and interacting with people from a professional level. They're people that are likely going to be interested in technology, in ministry, in leadership, in faith, things like that. That on a more professional side of things, and so I'm sharing content professionally on Twitter. And then LinkedIn, like Twitter, has a more professional feel. So Twitter, many people use personally, but then I use it professionally to promote the various elements and communication pieces. LinkedIn is very aligned to my Twitter account, so I use a lot of the same content on Twitter with LinkedIn. It is 100% professional for me. I should use LinkedIn more for networking and interacting, so private messaging within LinkedIn. I don't do a whole lot from a content engagement standpoint, although the content engagement elements of LinkedIn continue to grow. So I do push some content out on LinkedIn, all professional, all leadership oriented and technology focused. So that is how I differentiate. LinkedIn is similar to Twitter, but Twitter is more for content distribution. LinkedIn for me is more for personal one-to-one interaction. And then YouTube. YouTube has been a new platform for me. Now, I have always watched YouTube, and I would say it was 100% personal for me. And I have a personal YouTube channel and account where I'll upload some family videos and various things that I share up. But I've really not looked to grow that. I've really not looked to use that for anything other than just sharing videos with family and friends. But now I've created a YouTube channel where I am focused on social media technology insights. And so I'm here to be your social media guide. And so I use YouTube as a platform to create video content and build a community around social media technology and leadership. And so so I am now using YouTube professionally, and I've created a business account here on YouTube to engage a new audience and build a new community on this platform around that professional nature of interest with business leadership and technology. And then the last social network that I want to mention for me is Instagram. Instagram is probably 90% personal and 10% professional. Now, Instagram has a lot of layers, and it's matured a lot, and the attention is growing. And so I am paying a lot of attention to Instagram, but I'm still using it primarily personally. So I will use it personally while paying attention to it professionally for something to learn from, but I'm not using it professionally to drive a lot of engagement with my content and drive a lot of engagement professionally. I'm more just using it to connect with people personally and learn it personally so that I can also then use it professionally. And so I'm still learning of how I engage most effectively on Instagram, but creating unique content, native content just for that platform. One of the things that Instagram has done a great job of is they don't let you use things like Hootsuite to schedule content out to the platform, and so you have to manually upload content, which really keeps the content more pure. So it's not just like I'm gonna create it here and just spread it out everywhere. You have to manually do a lot of it and using your mobile device to do that. And so it's a little more complicated and challenging for marketers, which I think creates that level of purity within the platform as a whole. So I love Instagram. The engagement continues to increase with Instagram stories. And so I'm using it a lot. Personally, I consider it a micro vlog. So if you've seen that episode here of the vlog, so that's how I'm differentiating the social networks. I would love to hear how you differentiate social networks. How do you create unique content for each platform? How do you remain present everywhere yet have your boundaries to where knowing you can't be present everywhere? The last thing I want to say to this is I also use a social media management tool. I use Sprout Social to monitor a lot of the engagement across a lot of these platforms. So as I get comments and messages in among these different platforms, it allows me to monitor that in one place and be more responsive. So it does help me to be present in multiple places at one time from a community engagement standpoint, because what we don't want to do is just create content and just spew it everywhere. We want to create great content that's native and natural for each of these platforms. They're continuing to find their own unique niche audience and community, and we begin to build communities on that. We want to be present. So we don't want to just share content and disappear, but we want to share content and engage community and be engaged in that community that is developing. So I hope my experiences and my learnings as I continue to learn and figure out how to differentiate content and engagement on each social network is helpful for you as you figure out the same and you build your rhythms and systems to how you differentiate on social media.